Hi, Dr. Bernard here. You might know me from the channel Chubby Emu. This is Heme Review, which is my second channel. This is a different video, different title, different thumbnail, more in-depth topic. I recently described a man who took too much fiber supplement and it blocked his colon. This is actually not as uncommon as people think because based on how that particular fiber supplement works, it could cause a variety of problems. Psyllium husk is a natural product derived from plants. It's known as a bulk laxative, which means that it absorbs water into the colon in order to move things along. The way that it does this is that it lowers surface tension to allow that water to enter into the intestines. In general, you want dietary fiber, whether it's from fruits, vegetables, grains, or psyllium husk fiber supplement, because it helps retain water in the stool, which in turn reduces transit time in the intestines to help things move along. There's some hot takes from my favorite place on the internet where people say that because fiber is indigestible, why would anyone want to take it? Think of your gastrointestinal tract like a big city highway. Keep it moving. No one likes it when things get backed up. Your intestines are designed to pull nutrients and water out of the food that you've eaten. Having fiber hold on to water into the stool lubricates the intestines and to a degree prevents those intestines from pulling out too much water. If the stool becomes dehydrated and hard, then it's more difficult to move things along. If something gets blocked, things will continue to pile on inside. If it's really hard, then it'll stretch the walls of the intestines, which could induce a stretch reflex because your whole GI tract is a line of muscle. But when that stretch happens and a solid is in place that can't be moved, the flow of blood to the gastrointestinal muscles will start to get cut off and then cause some of the tissue to necrose. Then the walls become weak because they're not alive, and it can cause stercoral perforation. Stercoral, referring to feces, as all of it starts to leak into the abdomen, causing peritonitis. And here's the thing about psyllium husk fiber. While it helps keep water in the stool to keep things moving along in the intestines, if you don't mix it with enough water, you can't expect that your gut has enough water in it. So it becomes kind of like a jelly-like consistency. If you mix even more powder, thinking that the more fiber, the better, then it becomes thick and sticky to the point where anyone would be surprised that it wouldn't block the stomach or the intestines. Here, I've mixed about a pound of psyllium husk fiber supplement in 2 liters of water. Look at how quickly it absorbs the water on contact. But after some mixing, it quickly becomes a clay-like consistency. As it starts to absorb more and more water, it starts to become like a jelly consistency. And if you have water on your hands, like how the walls of your intestines would have some moisture, you'll see that the psyllium block becomes kind of slippery, although the more I rub into it, the stickier it becomes as it starts to absorb that water on my hands. If you add more water to psyllium after it had congealed, you'll notice that it roughly maintains the same shape and just continues to absorb even more water. If you try to squeeze it, it's not easy to break up. Actually, it's really difficult to even cut it up. So once it's formed, it becomes hard to break up. Adding more water causes it to expand even more. All of this meaning that if anyone who takes psyllium without mixing it with enough water at first, they can cause some trouble for their stomach and their intestines. In some cases, people might mix it with some water and drink it while it's still a slushy-like consistency because it does take a minute or two for it to absorb water. This only means that it can become like a jelly in the stomach and then further harden as it keeps going down into the intestines. And then it can cause blockage leading to an impaction. This happens maybe more often than we think because psyllium is made from plants. The mass that gathers in the stomach is called a phytobezoar. Phyto, referring to plants, and bezoar from an old Persian word meaning antidote, but now referring to a partially digested or undigested mass that's spawned in the stomach. Other kinds of bezoars are trichobezoars, which we know as hairballs, lactobezoar, which is a mass of milk proteins, and pharmacobezoar, which is made of medicines and excipients. Psyllium husk as a supplement is generally regarded as safe. Follow what it says on the label though, because it definitely mentions mixing it with enough water. When you do mix it properly with the right amounts of water, you'll notice that it does become a little bit more viscous, but if mixed well, it doesn't settle at the bottom. Some people prefer the unflavored variants, or here in the US we have the Metamucil-like orange flavor type of psyllium. And some trials have suggested that it does have some health benefits, like lowering cholesterol levels in people who have high blood cholesterol, as well as possibly helping with inflammatory bowel disease by maybe helping with the gut microbiome. That's the bacteria that live inside of your GI tract. Also, some fiber has been noted to help with blood sugar control, so it could be helpful in diabetes. Remember, you have to be careful with all of this because, like with anything, taking too much of it, and in this case, taking it the wrong way, can, one, be very painful if it blocks something in your stomach and your intestines. I can speak from personal experience to that. And two, remember that this is a product that comes from plants. So some people, though it's rare, can be allergic to psyllium and have a life-threatening reaction to it that's also been described in literature. So please be careful with your psyllium husk fiber. I'm speaking from personal experience. It is very painful if something gets blocked, and it's very frustrating because it takes a long time for anything to actually start to move through again. Thank you so much for watching. Check out the main Chubby Emu video about a student who drank 2 liters of psyllium husk fiber supplement, link in the description below. Or if you'd like to listen to a case of fecal impaction that happened in a grandma with dementia, check out the audio version of this podcast, also linked in the description below. Take care of yourself and be well.